Here we are on lovely Māngere Mountain in the southern part of the Auckland volcanic field. It's a lovely blue sky winter's day, but the wind is blowing a howling gale, and so hopefully my hat won't blow off. Now, Māngere Mountain here is a volcanic cone, one of the Auckland's 53 volcanoes. Of the 53 volcanoes, approximately 25, we have cones like this still left here in Auckland. And Māngere Mountain is one of the very best examples of a volcanic cone in the Auckland volcanic field. So all these volcanic cones in Auckland were produced by one style of eruption. The magma coming up initially would have hit groundwater and we'd have had wet explosive eruptions. But once all that water was used up, we switched to a dry style of eruption. And that is the style that produced the volcanic cones of Auckland. The magma that comes up is full of dissolved gas. As that magma reaches the surface, the pressure starts to be released and the gas comes out of solution and starts to froth up the magma, and it fountains through the vent as a fountaining of hot frothy lava. As that hot frothy lava flies through the air, it cools and solidifies and becomes a solid frothy rock we call scoria. The scoria collects around the vent that it's coming out of and progressively builds up a scoria cone, often with a crater in the middle of it and at the top. While some Auckland volcanoes only have one crater, Māngere Mountain has these two. When we look at these craters, scoria erupted from either one of them hasn't built up in the other one, which suggests to us that both craters would have been fountaining and active at the same time. So here we are on the ridge that surrounds the second crater, and along this ridge there are a whole lot of deep semi-rectangular pits, as we can see here. This and the other pits were all made by pre-European Maori. They are commonly called kumara pits. That is, they were used for the storage of kumara. Here's an exposure of scoria that was fountained out of the crater and landed here and built up the slopes of the cone. You can see it's quite frothy and it's very loose. And because it was so loose and easy to get at, the scoria cones were the target of early quarrying in colonial Auckland. And so unfortunately, Auckland has lost a number of its volcanic cones, and many of the others, including this one, have been scarred by some of those early quarrying activities. Today, however, we're fortunate that all quarrying of the scoria cones in Auckland is stopped, and all the remaining cones are now in reserve. Over here, we can see scattered shells eroding out of the scoria bank here. They were brought up here as part of the food resources for the pre-European Maori who were living up here. So we're now at the top of Māngere Mountain, and we're starting to get some wonderful views, panoramic views, over this part of Auckland. Out here we can see the Manukau Harbour, and stretching out below the mountain, all the way to the edge of the Manukau Harbour, is the suburb of Māngere Bridge, and in the distance, the great green fields of Ambury Regional Park, we can see there. Now all this flat land in front of us, in fact, was made by Māngere Volcano. It's part of the volcano itself, in fact. And these are lava flows that flowed out from the base of the scoria cone. So that magma that was coming up and the gas was coming out and producing the fire fountaining which built Māngere Mountain scoria cone left behind flat magma with very little gas in it. And when that magma came up inside the vent, then it pushed its way through the base of the loose scoria. In this instance, it's flowed out from many different places around the base of the scoria cone and flowed off across the Manukau Flats here and produced these lava flow field. The whole area is about 500 hectares of lava flows here. And in the 50,000 years since Māngere Mountain erupted, developed quite a thick covering of rich volcanic soil. And in pre-European times, there would have been extensive cultivations on these flat lands of Māngere Bridge area. So Māngere Mountain itself and this particular crater is unique in the Auckland volcanic field in that it has a small hill It overlies the very vent in which all that scoria was fountained out of. The hill itself is made of solid basalt lava, which is quite different from the frothy scoria that made the cone itself. And this gives us an idea of how this hill was formed. Towards the end of the eruption of Māngere Mountain 50,000 years ago, the magma in the vent stood still and slowly cooled from the top down and produced a thick plug of solid lava in the top of the vent. But underneath, there was still moving magma a little bit, and gas was coming out of solution and building up pressure underneath that plug of solid lava. And eventually that pressure built up so much that the plug was suddenly pushed up like a cork out of a bottle, out of the vent, and formed the hill. As that plug went up, the gas and some of that gloopy, nearly solid lava that was coming through was thrown out from a number of different explosion craters, these small holes that we can see around the edges of that particular hill. The semi-solid lava flew through the air and spun around to create spindle shapes or volcanic bombs. As they were flying through the air, they were also cooling and becoming harder, so that when they landed on the ground, they captured that volcanic bomb shape that we can see. That's a nice fusiform shape. You can see its shape here as we go round. This is 1.5 meter long spindle shape or fusiform lava bomb that's come out of this crater here. It's a classic and it's a really nice specimen. There's only one or two specimens like this from the Auckland field, and they're in the Auckland Museum. The fountaining coming out of this crater produced these ramparts right around it. You can see that some parts are much higher than others. And we think the high points are where the wind was blowing from the opposite direction and blew the fountain this way. So for a while, the scoria was all landing in one part of the crater rim and built up these higher portions that we can see around the crater. Over here in the east, there is a very low area of the ramparts. And we think the explanation for this is that the lava coming out through the scoria cone flowed out to the east. And as it was flowing out, it carried away or rafted away some of the scoria ramparts on that side and carried them off on top of that flowing lava. And there are scoria mounds in the trees over beyond the playing fields there, which we think is some of this rafted scoria cone that was carried off by the lava flow as it flowed out. So here we are on one of the three or higher points of Māngere Mountain. You can see a large circular pond with an island in the middle. That's another of the 53 volcanoes of Auckland called Māngere Lagoon Explosion Crater. It was produced probably only days to weeks before Māngere Mountain itself then started erupting. That's it for Māngere Mountain. We've had a wonderful explore and I hope you've enjoyed it as well.